So, dear students, now let's start with the topic of kinetic theory of gases. The very first thing, let's discuss about a gas. When we just talk about a gas, you have studied about a gas in your previous classes also, that gas is a collection of large number of molecules. More precisely, we should write large number of free molecules in random motion. When large number of collection of molecules are in random motion and molecules are free to move, this random motion, which we call Brownian motion, that I think all of you have studied in your previous classes also, such a collection of molecules we call a gas. And similarly about a gas, we'll study about kinetic theory of gases when we talk about KTG. Kinetic theory of gases basically analysis and behavior of these molecules are studied under kinetic theory of gases. Or you can say the study of analysis and behavior of these random motion of free molecules or gas molecules is called or is termed as kinetic theory of gases. In this topic, we are going to mainly study about kinetic theory of gases, its postulate. And basically, kinetic theory of gases depends also on the difference of real and practical gases. When the gaseous discoveries were being done, an ideal gas was defined. We are going to discuss about an ideal gas and later we'll compare this ideal gas with real gases available in nature. There are lot many differences between the definition of an ideal gas and the real gases which are available in nature. And to analyze or account of these differences, various postulates of kinetic theory of gases are defined. Let's study about postulates of kinetic theory of gases. Let's discuss the postulates of kinetic theory of gases. As just now we have discussed that to analyze kinetic theory of gases, we define an ideal gas. And the assumptions taken for a gas to be ideal are called postulates of kinetic theory of gases. There are many assumptions we consider for a real gas so that it can be treated as an ideal gas. Let's discuss these assumptions one by one. The very first assumption of kinetic theory of gases is we consider that size of a gas molecule is negligible. However, when we talk about volume of a gas, volume of a gas is actually defined as volume available for molecular motion. Actually, gaseous volume is the volume in which the free molecules of gas can randomly move. So, actually volume of a gas is, say if it is taken in a container, it is defined as container volume minus volume occupied by all gas molecules. Because actually the volume available for motion is not exactly the container volume. Container volume minus the volume occupied by the gas molecules, because actually gas molecules are also having a specified size, and because of which the total volume available for molecular motion is less than the container volume. So, this defined as the volume of gas. But every time the calculation of this volume becomes quite difficult, because if we change the number of molecules of a gas in a container, the volume of gas changes. So, for an ideal gas, we define that size of a gas molecule is negligible. And using this assumption, we can simply state that gas volume can always be taken as container volume. So, for calculation ease, such an assumption is taken, because in various type of experimental analysis, we consider container volume as gas volume, and after analysis, the results are analyzed and modified corresponding to the actual volume available for molecular motion. We'll see some problems based on this also. Let's take up the second assumption of kinetic theory of gases, in which we study that all molecules of a gas collide elastically with each other as well as with container walls. Basically, as we have studied that gas molecules are moving freely in a random motion, and during random motion they continuously collide either with each other or with the container walls. We can also define about collisions in a gas. These are of two types. First is the collision between molecule and molecule. And the second type, when gas is taken in a vessel, then it is molecule and container walls. And in these two types of collisions, we assume that all these collisions are elastic collisions. Elastic collisions are considered for an ideal gas, because practically there are no collisions which are perfectly elastic. So, always during collision, a gas loses or dissipates energy, and which we ignore for first hand mathematical analysis. And we can also state, due to continuous collisions, a gas exerts pressure whether on container walls or on another interface wherever gas is in contact. So, due to continuous collisions, only a gas exerts pressure. This is our second postulate of kinetic theory of gases. And in the third postulate, we assume that during random motion, gas molecules do not interact with each other. Obviously, we are excluding the time of collision. We are talking about random motion of gas molecules. During motion, they do not interact with each other. That means gas molecules won't exert any force on each other whenever they pass nearby. So, we can directly state, if there is no interaction, the potential energy of interaction of gas molecule is always zero. So, we can always state that total energy of a gas is always equal to sum of kinetic energy of all of its molecules. As no interaction implies no potential energy, so what is the kinetic energy of random motion of particles? That is termed as total energy of gas. Let's come to assumption number 4. Next postulate of kinetic theory of gases is defined as, when molecules collide, the time of contact is negligible compared to the time between two collisions. Time between two successive collisions. This time between two successive collisions is also termed as relaxation time and denoted by the symbol TR. And we just ignore the time of contact because actually the force between two molecules when they collide is a short range force. And in case of short range forces, it appears for a negligible duration when they are just in contact. And we can state the time between two successive collisions is very large compared to the time of contact. And the next postulate for kinetic theory of gases is all molecules of a gas are in continuous random motion called Brownian motion. I think you all studied about Brownian motion in your early classes, and for Brownian motion we can state this is a motion in which direction of motion of a particle changes randomly at each collision, and between two collisions particle travel in a straight line path. Straight line path between two collisions. You can state if a gas molecule is moving in a straight line, it strikes with the other molecule. This collision, its direction changes randomly. And when again it strikes, its direction again changes randomly. At every collision, you can state the direction of motion randomly changes whenever a particle collides with another particle. So you can state in this collision, the path of the molecular motion is totally random. It can be taken as a random zigzag path. Here you can state the direction is changing randomly at every collision. So the similar path is being followed by each and every molecule. So overall you can state the picture of the path of all the molecules is quite a complex one. But always remember that between two successive collisions particle travel in a straight line path. We can also state the distance traveled, mean distance traveled by a particle between two successive collisions is denoted by the term, the symbol lambda m, and it is called mean free path. This also you should keep in mind. This is a standard term. We are going to discuss about it in detail in coming sections of the topic. The next assumption of kinetic theory of gases is the effect of gravity is negligible on gas molecules. Or more precisely, we can state as effect of gravity is negligible. The effect of this is in a container. Density of gas molecules is uniform everywhere. It does not change with height, you can state. Because practically when in a container a gas is taken, at the bottom of container due to gravity, most of molecules are collected. And the density of molecules is higher at the bottom compared to middle or top sections of the container. So for an ideal gas, we assume that no gravitational effects are considered on a gas molecule so that everywhere the density of gas can be taken constant. The last postulate of kinetic theory of gases is all gases obey ideal gas law at all temperatures and pressures, which is stated as, I hope in your early classes you might have covered the gas law, which is stated as PV equals to nRT, where P is the gas pressure, V is the volume of gas, which is generally taken as a container volume, and nR taken as a number of moles of gas, R as a universal gas constant, and T is the absolute temperature of gas. Here number of moles, N, can be easily calculated as mass of gas by molar mass. You can always keep in mind, mass of molecules divided by molar mass gives you the number of moles. It can also be given as number of molecules upon Avogadro number, because you all know that in 1 mole of particles, Avogadro number of particles are found. So, total number of moles can be written as total number of molecules upon Avogadro number. So, just keep in mind that an ideal gas is the one which obeys ideal gas law at all temperature and pressures. Whereas generally it is observed that real gases behave like ideal gases only at very high temperature and very low pressure. And at low temperature and at very high pressure, you can state this gas law is deviated from this form. But that is not under the scope of our lecture, so we'll only study about ideal gases and the assumptions we have studied for real gases. And if you carefully analyze all these assumptions, you'll be very easily able to analyze the basic difference between a real gas and an ideal gas.